welcome to our Product Inspiration series, in which we explore the forefront of innovations across intelligent CX from SAP. My name is Sven, and today I'm pleased to talk to Punav, our product manager for Digital Selling Workspace in SAP Sales Cloud version 2. Punav, thank you so much for taking the time. How are you doing today?
Hi Sven, thanks for having me. I'm really excited for our session today.
Awesome. Hey, before we embark on an exciting product demo together with you, I would like to ask you three short questions to begin with. Could you please shed some light on what's happening in the area of Sales Cloud version 2 and especially in the area of Digital Selling Workspace? Why is Digital Selling Workspace such a great new capability of Sales Cloud version 2, and what is our differentiating advantage compared to other solutions in the market?
Of course, Sven, I'm really excited to talk about Digital Selling Workspace, a new capability that we have enabled with SAP Sales Cloud V2. In today's world, with so many activities that are being performed online, Digital Selling Workspace will offer you just that. We've designed our UI meticulously so that the key sales users can monitor their key KPIs, assess their leads, and also their opportunities, and even furthermore. We have an enhanced, explicit view of each element, enhancing or the experience of our sales users, both for inside as well as the outbound sales processes. Integrated within the workspace, we have Task Manager, which gives you an enhanced comprehensive view of each task that you have to perform and plan an execution around it. We also have an email inbox within the workspace, allowing users to check their interactions, similar to Timeline, which also captures your recent interactions and you can find out the details about it.
Okay, that sounds great. What are the top areas of innovations that you want to point out today?
Admins, on the other hand, can customize the workspace based on user roles, which allows the users to have all the information needed for their day-to-day work. Flexibility being core to our design, we allow hiding, unhiding of different elements as well as sequencing. And the most important feature here is embedding a mashup. Embedding a mashup can help you with your S4 screens as well as some other applications that are built on BTP. Our future goal here is also to integrate Joule in our solution. So this would help our users not just to plan and execute, but help overall with the sales processes. With the launch of SAP Sales Cloud V2, our sales dashboard allows features which were previously unavailable. This new all-in-one designs provide comprehensive, optimal information processing for our sales users and their teams to take the sales and make decisions around. From prospecting to lead nurturing and opportunity management, we also propose some actionable proposals from playbook. Additionally, we also have a quick create actions so that the sales users can create other sales objects from within the workspace. We also have an integrated calendar system wherein users can manage their day efficiently. From here, we can allow users to create follow-up items such as appointment, task, create visits, as well as use emails with the predefined templates and also use our click-to-call features.
Wonderful. Punav, now that we have learned about the unique differentiators and the latest innovations that come with SAP Sales Cloud version 2, could you please enlighten us on how customers can embrace the new Digital Selling Workspace and related AI capabilities? Are there any prerequisites they have to be aware of before activating and using it?
The best part about SAP Sales Cloud V2 is all you need a user and access to Digital Selling Workspace. Of course, along with the other sales object as well, which are part of Digital Selling Workspace. Now let's have a closer look at the Digital Selling Workspace in action. When you log into SAP Sales Cloud V2, you can make out that there is a card on our UI in the homepage itself. You can directly navigate from here or also from the Work Center navigation on the top left. When we log into our workspace, we can see that there are multiple KPI cards given here so that the users have quick access to what is needed from them. Like we have for task, we can filter by today or all tasks assigned, similarly appointments, and you can check on whom it is created, also the lead conversion and the win rate. On the right hand panel, you can see who we have called recently, as well as there is a calendar access given for a quick day-to-day planning for the sales rep. On the workspace area on the left, we can see there are multiple object detailed view along with the create object for all the other objects that you can create from the workspace itself. To start our demo, we can go with the call list. We can see that it is mainly on telesales and it is on a my active call list. We have objectives here defining what is the purpose of this call list. There are multiple participants, all our contacts, and we have a start and end date. With this, we also have a call script allowing our telesales agent to access script easily when they are on calls, and there are multiple set of questions here. Other actions include calling, emails, etc. and a quick complete as well. We can make out here that there are some options. We can see the statuses, who is in open, who is scheduled. We can also filter based on some group by actions like type of participant that is added or the status. For a demo, let's try to now mail Allison here, and we can see that we are adding a template or a predefined words that we have created and just beautifying it here in our email editor, changing our subject. Here we can also use some templates from the defined email. This is from our workspace itself, direct access, but it has all the capabilities as an email editor provided. Once we are done with here, we can always send across the email for our participant, which allows us to just give them a brief about what we have for this prospective. On the overflow button here, we have different actions where you can make out what follow-ups have been created. If there are scripts, then what responses have been given for the script by this particular participant. We have also CTI integration, which is based on any of the providers that you can use and that we can access, and it is inbuilt in our system. So when we click and make a call, it automatically opens on the right side here as an overflow, as a different screen, which allows the users when they are on the call here, a sales rep, while on the call with Joe Wills, can get different answers to the script which we have assigned to our call list. So you can ask some quick questions, get the amounts here, and if you can see, there's a question which is mandatory mainly to understand the estimate when they want the solution, and such quick questions can be answered from here and submitted. This allows the users also or the sales rep to understand or estimate and focus on a particular participant based on the costing. Once you're done with the call or the script, you can define if it was a successful or not, or you can write a quick note for somebody else who will be looking into the phone call later. Something or a quick action item like we have here, like send out an email with a brochure. Once this is done, we can multiply, or we can see there are multiple actions on our UI as well. The call that we have made just now can be also depicted on the recently called screen here. You can check out the notes as well that we have given here. Once we are done and the call was successful, we know that Joe Wills was interested, so we are creating a follow-up lead on particular participant. So we know Joe Wills was interested in our AI feature which we are introducing, and we just assign the date or assign the account here, and we try to create a particular lead on this. Since it was a very good amount, we have named it, we have given the qualification as hot lead. Yep, once the lead is created, of course, you can go to the details view from here itself using view lead. But we also have a lead option within our workspace where you can see if a lead, I'm an owner of a lead, I can see all those leads. You could also see there are some filters which had none, which had due today, which you can make out on the activities. Here we can see there are no activities available. So what we are doing is we are trying to create an activity here, which means I can define or plan a particular lead or how to nurture it and create different activities on top of it, like a task or an appointment. Once this is done, I know I have to focus on this task on a particular day or a particular time. This is my responsibility. If I then change into, say, a different filter, which is due today, it also shows us the lead that we just created from the telesales, from call list. So here we can see that there is AI feature that we have created, and it is based on the account.
From here, you can also see the quick view if there are some details around it, or overview has something else, or somebody else has worked on it, or any activity that has happened based on timeline or people. On the right side here, on the right section, we can see multiple proposals here. These are proposals coming from playbook. Based on certain rules and conditions we defined in the system, all these proposals are coming here. The sales rep can choose what he wants to create as a task or not. It just helps the sales rep to gauge or what is the planning. It gives a proposal. So sales rep decides to create a task based on certain things, and he can create a task and then execute that. The same task would also be available in the task manager, or you can go from the details view from here when you got the pop-up of that view task. There are multiple other filters also, wherein we have some different qualification statuses or a lead status. We can see if a particular status is in open condition, or if it's in the sales ready condition, or if anything has been, for that matter, declined. Since there's nothing declined, we can always go back and remove the filter. There are different scores also given for the lead here, helping the sales rep to focus on a particular lead or a run after a particular lead. And like as I mentioned, in the quick view, we can gauge what has happened, like the activities are created here. The next step, that is from lead to opportunity, can also be based on the rights given to the user. You can also view the opportunity here. The opportunities also have proposals from playbooks coming in based on defined rules, or you can always create a new opportunity from here. Like anyone that you're talking to and you know that particular lead would be interested going further, you can always create an opportunity. Like in lead, we have different statuses which we can change here from one state to another within the workspace. You don't have to go to the lead itself. We can do it within the lead. Similarly, we also have the same for opportunity. Like this opportunity, for that matter, has good score of 75, and I know we have completed and we have won it. So the same opportunity, we can just save it's one due to product, and that also gives us our feature or the beautification here or gamification that it has won. Some confetti keeps falling. So there are multiple objects or multiple activities that you can run after, you can create here, and you can nurture this opportunity or work on this opportunity even further. Now here we have task manager, which is also embedded within the workspace with all the tasks that you can do, like a quick to call. You can see the action. If the action says it's an email, we have an email button already coming up here. Once the email is sent, you can already mark it complete with the quick complete action. There are some default task settings that you can also carry out within the workspace, wherein you can give based on priority or change the settings that you are as per user needs. And there are different filters here as well. Like you can plan your day, you have your day, you have the planned activities that you have created, and there are also the ones which are important. You can create a new task immediately here, just a quick create within the workspace. You can just enter a task, you can assign a particular account, give a priority, give a status, give a reminder, all that within this small task manager itself. Here I enter the account as Green Mile, then I select a primary contact that I'm interested in, and next step, what I want to do is know that it's a demo preparation, like I mentioned. Also, if it's a priority, I give it an urgent requirement. Similar to that, I can change the priority while creating. I can give a reminder itself, and anytime that I want to provide a date. So once this is done, I know that the task is already there itself. This allows the users also with different due dates or group by feature here as well. Another feature that we have is having our email integrated within the workspace, allowing users to directly check their summary of what they can have here, what they can create, what have been transpired, what communications have been happened, and users can see if it's an inbound email or an outbound email. And this probably provides different entities itself, like who was related in this, a change history allowing who created or who sent on at what date. So such details are present within our email workspace. Sales Navigator is another tab. If you have Sales Navigator access within the SAP Sales Cloud V2, you can always connect it with your LinkedIn and then also do your prospecting work. Another major feature which we have is adaptation. You can see that we can also adapt our KPI cards, hide, unhide them, and in future we are planning to even allow the users to create their own KPI sections from BTP and add it here. We also have adaptations of moving across a sequencing of tabs here. Now the calendar is first and then the recently called move to later. We can also create a different tab, like something from an external system or an external app that I've created. I just have to say apply. I have to add this particular mashup from mashup authoring in our extensibility settings. And once it's authorized there, you can always just select from the mashup which is provided and just add it here. Like here, I have some CPQ related mashup which I enter and that will be here as well. Like you can use another SAP system or any other BTP app system that you have created, any external. So that allows our system or allows the dashboard to be adaptable to the next level, where it's just not limited to Sales Cloud V2, but any application that you want to go back and forth to. The best part about our workspace is also, like you saw just now, we can just collapse or expand our workspace entirely, allowing the users more space as and when they are needed. And here, like I'm showing, it's we are planning to allow users to add different KPI sections or smaller cards when users add it through different applications. So like we added the tab, similarly we can add the KPI as well. That's about it. I hope you really liked it. Thank you so much.
Welcome to the world of SAP Intelligent CX. Our comprehensive suite of applications seamlessly integrates front-end and back-end systems, providing a unified and streamlined approach to managing customer interactions. We incorporate artificial intelligence that allows your team to work smarter and faster, and our industry-tailored use cases and partner ecosystem empowers organizations to deliver extraordinary experiences, build lasting relationships, and drive sustainable growth. Our composable SAP Customer Experience Suite enables leading brands to understand and protect customer data, increase lifetime value with personalized journeys, close more business faster, drive consistently profitable commerce outcomes, and deliver automated and agent-assisted service. Learn how you can deliver extraordinary customer experiences. Visit sap.com/cx.